Okay, welcome to Hollywood Review with yours truly, Denise Harris. We're going to talk about the top 10 movies of the past week. Ooh, I wonder what it was. Okay, but we'll be right back. And as always, this is brought to you by King's Cannabis. See you in a minute.
Yeah. lawyer to turn the corner so he can corner ya. You're a corner, he's on ya. Out the corner of his corner, ya. He just saw you run. All you want is to rest, cause you can't run anymore, you're done. All he wants is to kill you in front of an audience. While everybody is watching in the party, applauding it. Here I sit while I'm caught up in deep thought again. Contemplating my next plot again. Swallowing a colonopin while I'm nodding in and out on the ottoman. Nick the Ramada in, holding on to the pill bottle then. Pick my finger and swirl it round the bottom and make sure I got all of it. Wake up naked at McDonald's with blood all over me, dead bodies behind the counter shit. Guess I must have just blacked out again, not again. It's 3 a.m. in the morning, put my key in the door. Bodies laying all over the floor and I don't remember how they got there. But I guess I must have killed them, killed them. I must have killed them, killed them. Sitting nude in my living room, it's almost noon. I wonder what's on the tube, maybe they'll show some boobs. Surfing every channel until I find Hannah Montana. Then I reach for the aloe and lanolin. Buzz all over the wall paneling, dismantling every candle on top of the fireplace mantling. Grab my flannel and my bandana then. Kiss the naked mannequin man again. You can see him standing in my front window if you look in. Who's used to using hallucinogens, causing illusions again, brain contusions again, cutting and bruising the skin, razor scissors and pins, Jesus, when does it end, phases that I go through, days that I'm so confused, days that I don't know who gave these molecules to me, what am I gonna do, hey, the prodigal son, the diabolical one, very methodical when I slaughter them. I must have killed them, killed them. I said, it's 3 a.m. in the morning. Put my key in the door. Bodies laying all over the floor. And I don't remember how they got there. But I guess I must have killed them, killed them. She put the lotion in the bucket. It puts the lotion on the skin. Or else it gets the holes again. She puts the lotion in the bucket. It puts the lotion on the skin. Or else it gets the holes again. Lights and gas, last night was a blast. I can't quite remember when I had that much fun up a half pint of a Jack. My last bike and a half, a flashlight up Kim Kardashian's ass. I remember the first time I dismembered a family member. December, I think it was. I was having drinks with my cousin. I wrapped them in Christmas lights, pushed them into the stinking tub, cut him up into pieces. And just when I went to drink his blood, I thought I ought to drink his bath water. That ought to be fun. That's when my days of serial murder, manslaughter begun. Me, that might be an artery, son. Your blood curdling screams just don't seem to bother me none. It's 3 a.m. and here I come, so you should probably run. A secret passageway around here, man, there's got to be one. Oh no, there's probably none. He can scream all that he wants, top of his lungs. But ain't no stopping me from chopping him up, up. Cause it's 3 a.m. in the morning. Put my key in the door. Body's laying all over the floor. And I don't remember how they got there, but I guess I must have killed them. Killed them. I must have killed them, killed them.
Yeah.
Okay, hope you're enjoying that Friday the 13th music tribute. Got a happy Friday the 13th. Thanks for stopping by, Sonia. Have a great night. Typing, guys, so give me a minute. Happy Friday the 13th, right? It's still technically the 13th. So, who watched the Friday the 13th marathon? Of course. Nothing's better than the original, right? Have a great night, hon. So, we're going to get started. Hopefully everybody had a great Friday the 13th. Ooh. Now comes fall and Halloween. Yay! So, another couple days, it will be officially fall. You're welcome, honey. Thank you. So let's get started on the top 10 movies. Of course, It Chapter 2 is number 1. If you have not seen the movie, I really highly recommend it, okay? The cast is amazing. Bill Hader, James McAvoy, oh my God, Jessica Chastain. If you remember, Jessica Chastain played in Crimson Peak, she played Tom Hiddleston's sister, and I can't think of the name of her, but that's who she played, and she was a total freak out in that. This cast was amazing. If you look at their kid counterparts that they're playing as adults, you could actually picture them looking like that. It is amazing. It really is. according to Rotten Tomatoes. And I have to tell you something about Rotten Tomatoes. They were kind of criticized for how they do their ratings. I'm still going to use them for now, but they're really kind of skewed. So, with that being said, the critics say, of course, It Chapter 2 proves bigger doesn't always mean scarier for horror sequels. And I thought it was just as. I mean, it was a great movie. It was a fine cast, faithful approach to the source material that keep this follow-up afloat. Oh, play on words, say it right. So, like I said, I highly recommend it. We'll talk about this in a week or two when most people have seen it. I don't want to do spoilers, so. But it's an amazing movie. Totally. Loved it. Loved it. Evil resurfaces in Derry. The Losers Club reunites in a return to where it all began with It Chapter 2. The conclusion to the highest grossing horror film of all time. 27 years after the Losers Club defeated Pennywise, he has returned to terrorize the town of Derry once more. They have long gone their separate ways. However, the kids are disappearing again. So Mike, the only one of the group to remain in their hometown, calls the others home. Damaged by the experiences of their past, they must each conquer their deepest fears to destroy Pennywise once and for all. And he has become deadlier than ever. James McAvoy, Jessica Chastain, Bill Hader, Isaiah Mustafa as Mike, and he sounds like him. Jay Ryan as Ben Hascom, James Ransone as Eddie, and these—they're like I said, the cast they put together here really. If you look at it, they look like they're kid counterparts. Totally freaky. But they did an excellent job, I thought. Okay, number two, Angel Has Fallen. Rotten Tomatoes, 39%. Audience score, 93. Go by the audience score, okay? Critics say, cut from the same rough cloth, as its predecessors, Angel Has Fallen rounds out a mostly forgettable action trilogy in a fittingly mediocre fashion. However, apparently, the audience disagrees with you, critics. 93% by the critics. When there is an assassination attempt on U.S. President Alan Trumbull, played by Morgan Freeman, of course, his trusted confidant, Secret Service agent Mike Banning, is wrongfully accused and taken into custody. After escaping from capture, he becomes the man on the run and must evade his own agency and outsmart the FBI in order to find the real threat to the president. Desperate to uncover the truth, Banning turns to unlikely allies to clear his name, keep his family from harm, and save the country from imminent danger, of course. Gerard Butler, of course, as Mike Banning, Morgan Freeman, as President Trumbull, Jada Pinkett Smith, Lance Reddick, I always liked Lance Reddick, Tim Blake Nelson, Piper Perabo. So, Angel Has Fallen. Okay, good deal. Number three is Good Boys. 79% tomato meter, 86% audience again. More than, okay, follow the audience score, okay. Good Boys is undermined by an eagerness to repeatedly indulge in profane humor, but its appealing cast and ultimately thoughtful message often shine through. Okay. After being invited to his first kissing party, 12-year-old Max is panicking because he doesn't know how to kiss. Eager for some pointers, Max and his best friend, Thor, Lucas, decide to use Max's dad's drone, which Max is forbidden to touch, of course, to spy, they think, on a teenage couple making out next door. But when things go ridiculously wrong, the drone is destroyed. Desperate to replace before Max's dad, gets home, the boy skips school and set off on an odyssey of especially bad decisions involving some accidentally stolen drugs, frat house paintball, and running both from the cops and terrifying teenage girls. So there you go. Jacob Tremblay is Max. Keith Williams as Lucas. Brady Noon as Thor. Molly Gordon as Hannah. Lil Rel Howery as Lucas's dad. Will Fort as Max's dad. So there you go. Good boys. Number four, The Lion King. Of course, it's still up there. 53% tomato meter, 88% audience. I don't know what's up with this, you know, their thinking and the critics. The critics say, while it can take pride in its visual achievements, The Lion King is by the numbers retelling that lacks the energy and heart that made the original so beloved. Though for some fans, that may be just enough. They are harsh, man. Harsh. Get a grip. And we all know about The Lion King. Simba idolizes his father, King Mufasa, and takes to heart his own royal destiny. Not everybody in the kingdom celebrates the new cub's arrival. Scar, Mufasa's brother and former heir to the throne, has plans of his own. With help from a curious pair of newfound friends, Simba will have to figure out how to grow up and take back what is rightfully his, of course. Donald Glover as Simba, James Earl Jones as Mufasa, Billy Eichner as Timon, Seth Rogen as Pumbaa, Beyonce Knowles as Nayla. Okay. Number five, Fast and Furious presents Hobbs and Shaw. Again, 67% tomato meter, 88% audience, okay? And the critics say Hobbs and Shaw doesn't rev as high as the franchise's best installment, but gets decent mileage out of its well-matched stars and over-the-top action sequences. I don't know. Do they even watch the movies? I'm not sure. Critics, I never go by what the critics say. Okay. Ever since hulking lawman Hobbs, a loyal agent of America's diplomatic security service, and lawless outcast Shaw, a former British military elite operative, first faced off in 2015's Furious 7, the duo have swapped smack talk and body blows as they've tried to take each other down. But when cybergenetically enhanced anarchist Brixton gains control of an insidious bio threat that could alter humanity forever, and best a brilliant and fearless rogue M16 agent, who just happens to be Shaw's sister, these two sworn enemies will have to partner up to bring down the only guy who might be badder than themselves. Of course, Dwayne Johnson is Luke, Jason Statham is Hobbs, Shaw, Dwayne Johnson is Hobbs, Idris Elba is Brixton, he's a bad guy, Vanessa Kirby is Hattie Shaw, Cliff Curtis is Jonah, Helen Mirren as Queenie. I love Helen Mirren, she's just awesome. Number six, Overcomer. I have not heard of this movie. But I guess we'll find out about it together here, right? 50% tomato meter, 98% audience score. So, critics say, no critic consensus yet. This movie is about life changes overnight for Coach John Harrison when his high school basketball team and state championship dreams are crushed under the weight of unexpected news. When the largest manufacturing plant shuts down and hundreds of families leave their town, John questions how he and his family will face an uncertain future. After reluctantly agreeing to coach cross-country, say that 10 times, John and his wife Amy meet an inspiring athlete who's pushing her limits on a journey toward discovery. Inspired by the words and prayers of a newfound friend, John becomes the least likely coach, helping the least likely runner attempt the impossible in the biggest race of the year. Alex Kendrick as John, Priscilla Shire as Olivia, Cherry Rigby as Amy, Cameron Arnett, Beth Davies as Coach Myers. So, Overcomer. Not heard of this till now. Number 7, Dora's still up there. And like I said, I don't know when Dora grew up, but okay. 84% tomato meter, 88% audience. Critics say, led by a winning performance from Is the Devil Moaner, Dora and the Lost City of Gold is a family-friendly adventure that retains the source material's youthful spirit. Having spent most of her life exploring the jungle with her parents, nothing could prepare Dora for her most dangerous adventure ever. High school. Always the explorer, Dora quickly finds herself leading Boots, her best friend, the monkey, Diego, a mysterious jungle inhabitant, and a ragtag group of teens on a live-action adventure to save her parents and solve the impossible mystery behind a lost city of gold. Isabella Boner as Dora, Eugenio Derbez as Alejandro, Michael Pena as Cole, her father, Eva Longoria as Alina, her mom, Adriana Barraza. So, Dora and the Lost City of Gold. Number 8, Ready or Not. Now, this looks pretty good, I think. I would go see this, absolutely. 88% tomato meter, 80% audience. Critics say, sweet is smart, subversive, and darkly funny. Ready or Not is a crowd-pleasing horror film with giddily entertaining bite. So there you go. This looks really good. It really does. Ready or Not follows a young bride as she joins her new husband's rich, eccentric family in a time-honored tradition that turns into a lethal game with everyone fighting for their survival. This looks really good. Samara Weaving, Adam Brody, Mark O'Brien. He's a stop. Andy McDowell. So, there you go. Ready or Not. That one I would see. It looks really good. Okay, number 9, Scary Stories to Tell in the Dark. And I need to see this one yet. Tomato meter, 79%. Audience, 72%. Critics say, like the best-selling series of books that inspired it, Scary Stories to Tell in the Dark opens a creepy gateway into horror for younger genre enthusiasts. I would see it. It's 1968. Change is blowing in the wind, but seemingly far removed from the unrest in the cities is a small town of Mill Valley, where for generations the shadow of the Bellows family has loomed large. It is in their mansion on the edge of town that Sarah, a young girl with horrible secrets, turned her tortured life into a series of scary stories, written a book that has transcended time. Stories that have a way of becoming all too real for a group of teenagers who discover Sarah's terrifying tome. Ooh. Zoe Margaret Coletti, Michael Garza, Gabriel Rush, Austin Abrams, Dean Norris, Gil Bellows. Scary Stories to Tell in the Dark. Today would have been a good day for that. And number 10, Once Upon a Time in Hollywood. And I've not seen this and I really need to. 85% tomato meter, 80% audience. Thrilling, unrestrained, yet solidly crafted. Once Upon a Time in Hollywood tempers Tarantino's provocative impulses with the clarity of a mature filmmaker's vision. A little smug there, like they know. Quentin Tarantino is awesome. His 9th feature film is a story that takes place in L.A. in 1969 at the height of hippie Hollywood. The two lead characters are Rick Dalton, former star of a Western TV series, and his longtime stunt double Cliff Booth. Both are struggling to make it in Hollywood they can't recognize anymore. But Rick has a very famous next-door neighbor, Sharon Tate. Leonardo DiCaprio is Rick. Brad Pitt is Cliff. Margot Robbie as Sharon Tate. Luke Perry as Wayne. Dakota Fanning as Squeaky Fromp. Al Pacino. Marvin Schwartz. So, Once Upon a Time in Hollywood. Oh, yes, yes, yes. opening this week. We have the Goldfinch. That looked really interesting, actually. It's beautifully filmed, yet mostly inert. The Goldfinch mishandles its source material, flattening a complex narrative into an uninvolving discipline. Really? Ooh. 77% so far. It opened actually yesterday in some cities. It opened everywhere tonight. 77% audience so far. Ooh, harsh, harsh. The Goldfinch is the film adaptation of Donna Tartt's globally acclaimed bestseller of the same name. It won the 2014 Pulitzer Prize for Fiction and spent more than 30 weeks on the New York Times bestseller list. Theo Decker was 13 years old when his mother was killed in a bombing at the Metropolitan Museum of Art. The tragedy changes the course of his life, sending him on a stirring odyssey of grief and guilt, reinvention and redemption, and even love. Through it all, he holds on to one tangible piece of hope from that terrible day, a painting of a tiny bird chained to its perch, the Goldfinch. Ansel Eggert as Theodore Decker, Oakes Fegley as young Theodore, Finn Wolfhand, young Boris, Ashley Cummins, Willa Fitzgerald, the Goldfinch. That actually looked pretty good. The other one is Brittany Runs a Marathon, whatever the heck that is. There's a few others opening. Of course, look out for Zombieland 2. Can't wait for that. That's going to be freaking awesome. Cannot wait, cannot wait, cannot wait. That's going to be so good. So, what else is opening? Hustlers with J-Lo, of course. That looked interesting. Neither Wolf or Dog. One Cut of the Dead. And this is about 100% tomato meter. No audience yet, hasn't been seen. Brainy and bloody in equal measures, One Cut of the Dead reanimates the moribund zombie genre with a refreshing blend of formal daring and clever satire. That's a Japanese film. Looks really good, though. Cast of relative unknowns, a brilliantly disguised low budget, and an epic 37-minute opening. Single take makes Ueda's feature debut a bright, breezy, and laugh-out-loud hilarious zombie comedy. A film crew is shooting a zombie horror flick in an abandoned water filtration plant, allegedly used for human experiments by the military. And just as the director browbeats his actors and demands more special effects, a real zombie apocalypse erupts, much to his auteur delight. Packed with movie references, as mocky as they are loving, this relentless takedown of the living dead genre is a total blast. So, it is Japanese. If you have seen Train to Busan, you know that it's going to be good. Train to Busan was disturbing, to say the least. The zombies in that movie were... I was like, holy crap. Crazy movie, but it was brilliant. Brilliant. So I would want to see this one, absolutely. They have a whole take on this zombie thing, and they're awesome. Another one coming out, Freaks, Emily Hirsch, Bruce Dern, haven't heard that name in a while. 86, but that opens, these are movies opening this weekend. 86% tomato meter. Stocked with solid performances, Freaks is a clever sci-fi horror hybrid that suggests a bright future for co-writers and co-directors. Excuse me. Kept locked inside the house by her father, 7-year-old Chloe lives in fear and fascination of the outside world, where abnormals create a constant threat, or so she believes. When a mysterious stranger offers her a glimpse of what's really happening outside, Chloe soon finds out that while the truth isn't so simple, the danger is very real. Emil Hirsch, Bruce Dern, Grace Park, Amanda Crew, Lexi Colker.
so freaks. Awesome, awesome. So, yeah, I would definitely see that one cut of the dead. What else is on the Monos? Chain for Life. The Weeknd. Haunt. The Harvesters. The Haunt. What is that about? A group of friends look for the thrill of a lifetime when they enter a haunted house that supposedly brings their deepest, darker fears to life. Things get dangerous when they realize the haunted house scares may be more than make-believe. Okay. Of course. Gotta love it. Gonna be Halloween, too. Gotta love the movie. Okay, what's coming up in the future? Zombieland 2. Oh, yeah. Adam's Family movie will be coming out. Chasing Einstein, D-Day, let's see, coming soon, Three from Hell, of course, September 16th, so Three from Hell, Weird time for that. Three from Hell. Malibu Road. Rambo Last Blood. The 20th. Whatever. Ad Astra. That's supposed to be really good. Brad Pitt. Tommy Lee Jones. Downton Abbey. That's the 20th. Bloodline. The 20th. 25th. Abominable. Of course, that's for Judy. Let's see. Joker, October 4th. Joaquin Phoenix, Robert De Niro. This looks really, really good. Looking forward to seeing that. So, yes, Joker, Joaquin Phoenix. Looks really, really good. Pretenders, Memory. Little Monsters comes out. The Addams Family, October 11th. Animated, of course. It looks really good for the kids. Zombieland, October 18th. Double Dap. And they're all back. So, and Maleficent, Mistress of Evil, is back. So, there you go. Those are upcoming. Top DVDs and streaming. Echo in the Canyon, Yesterday, The Weeknd, Dark Phoenix, The Dead Don't Die with Bill Murray, Adam Driver, gotta get that, something just came out, what was it, gosh darn it, Aladdin, of course, came out already. What the heck was it? Hate that. Depraved will be out Tuesday, The Weeknd, Dark Phoenix. There's another one. Gosh darn it. If I think of it, I'll let you know. John Wick, been out, see it. Secret Life of Pets 2, absolutely, got to see that, that's been out, so, that's the top streaming and DVDs that are out, new releases, Yesterday, Evelyn, The Parting Glass, Super Size Me, Depraved, and The Weeknd, so, those are the ones, so, anyway, again, happy Friday the 13th. Of course, like I said, I have music for that. Give it a tribute. And, of course, the number one movie is It, Chapter 2. Again, I highly, highly recommend it. I thought it was, they did an amazing job with that. I really did. Of course, Zombieland 2 is going to be coming out. And we won't talk about It for another week or two because of spoilers. I don't want to spoil it for anybody. Just see it. Cannabi, you gotta see it. Absolutely, it was great. There's a part in there that's very disturbing. But anyway, you'll probably know it when you see it. What else is new? Don't forget, Sports Talk with Denise is back on Tuesdays. American Horror Story starts Wednesday, so the following Sunday will be our first podcast for American Horror Story 1984. That looks amazing. Fits right in with the Friday the 13th thing, the slashers. And, of course, Michael Myers coming up. So that one's going to be amazing. Walking Dead will return. We're going to have a full week. So, interesting. Let's see what else is going on. R.I.P. The great Eddie Money died today at age 70. So, thoughts and prayers out to fans, family, and friends, of course. excuse me, gave you my picks for football this week. We'll see how it plays out. Won last night, so that's one on the books. Trying to think what else is going on. Not a whole lot. So, have a great rest of your Friday the 13th. And to celebrate Friday the 3rd, don't go away and go anywhere. Freaks in the Basement is up next with our biggest freak, Chris Stevens. So continue on with your Friday night partying with our Freaks in the Basement. Don't go over that. Don't forget, check out Lad Brad, great podcast. So check KBLC links for him on Facebook. You can also go to KBLPLLC4 on YouTube to catch episodes, okay? What else? Like I said, the Sports Talk on Tuesday. And when American, when The Walking Dead comes back, we're going to have two shows. I'm going to have two shows on Tuesday. There's just no ifs, ands, or buts about that. I do the sports, record it, and play it, and then do Walking Dead live. Not sure. We'll have to wait and see how that works. Or do it 1 week, then Walking Dead record, then sports record, whatever. We'll figure it out. It's going to be busy with Halloween coming up, of course. Okay, I'm going to wrap it up with some more music for Friday the 13th and Jason. So have a great weekend. Again, don't forget, Freaks in the Basement up next. Have a great night, y'all. Peace out.
Hello? Hello? Oh, God, help us! Please, help us!
Halloween's coming a little early this year. How do you kill me? I am immortal, still here. I am the one that's insane. I see the blood in your veins. I've become one with the pain. I smell fear. We have been improperly introduced, Jason. Come here. I got a hook for you in the basement. I got a doctor, a nurse, a hag, and a hillbilly. It's 1 against 8, boy. You looking real silly.
Yeah, I'm ready. I'll go and grab my machete and watch your body pop, scatter, and drop like confetti. I'm superhuman. You just a bunch of amateurs. And my is please looking like a junior high janitor. I'm an undefeated evil in this twisted life. So when you're on the killing floor, you'll need more than a kitchen knife. I'm lurking in the shadows with a big surprise. Lift you high, slice your chin to thigh, you only live to die.
Who is the psycho killer of the match? Chasing through the woods, I can see their tracks. Now this ain't funny, so don't you dare laugh. Just another case of blood to bloodbath. Who is the psycho killer of the match? Chasing through the woods, I can see their tracks. Now this ain't funny, so don't you dare laugh. Just another case about the bloodbath.
I insist you give up this instance, cause I don't need these misfits to dismiss this dimwit that can't use his sixth sense to get kids with footprints that's going into this tent. How can you be this dense?
Listen. listen, this is strictly for vengeance. So if you die, don't take it personal, it's business. I slaughter and execute the global, bear witness. My carnage will consume the souls of my victims.
Ha! You call yourself a killer? You drown in the lake. I murdered my own sister, killed my own kinfolk. How did you catch this bimbo? Just throw a freaking bear trap in front of an open window. You know how many people try to chop me up? You look like you stand in front of Nets blocking hockey pucks. Little Jason probably fled by the wayside, but don't try to get away, you'll be dead by the daylight.
When I show up, it's something like a slasher flick. The only difference is there's no sequel after this. Ask yourself, how long will you last? Nobody cared about who I was till I put on the mask. They call me Freak Show and drown me down in Crystal Lake. They all thought that I was dead, big mistake. They really think that they can hide behind a tree and kneel. I make their skin curl right before they bleed and spill. Their guts all over the floor, watch them scream and squeal. My mama told me to murder, I got some things to kill. And I would do the same to you. I know it seems surreal, but now you little killers know that Mr. Voorhees is real.
Who is the psycho kid with the mad? Chasing through the woods, I can see their tracks. Now this ain't funny, so don't you dare laugh. Just another case about to bloodbath. Who is the psycho killer of the mad? Chasing through the woods, I can see their tracks. Now this ain't funny, so don't you dare laugh. Just another case about to bloodbath.
don't stop, Jason. They deserve to die. Make them suffer like we did.
You're with your baby.